Let them believe in us, because only we will be able to deliver on the promises that we made to them. Right now, it is no longer enough to remind them that we fought for their freedom. They associate us with incompetence. Sometimes they associate us with corruption. Sometimes they associate us with cronyism, with patronage. You have to know somebody they believe to be able to get a job in government. You have to know somebody to get a tender. You have to know somebody to get ABCD. We should show them that this is not the case. What we in the ANC want is true quality cadres who serve the people first and foremost. Government are a means to an end. The state is only a means to access. State is not a means to access resources. Our state-owned enterprises have become a drain on our economy simply because they've allowed foreign strains to get into them. We must change that, and here I want to borrow some wise words from OR Tambo. And he says, I want to tell you, comrades, that not everything the enemy has done wrong. Not everything that they did was wrong. Let's learn from them how they did things right for themselves and copy that which they did right for themselves and do it for our own people. And to use the examples of the SOEs. This is one area where the apartheid state made sure that their poor people were looked after. Our SOEs are not performing that which the Afrikaners use them for most effectively. We need to tighten our governance and ensure that our people are treated with respect and dignity in our hospitals and home affairs, wherever they are, and treated with efficiency as well. We need to deal with corruption, both in the public and private sector. In exile, we had no corruption in the ANC, and when we found strains of corruption, we knew that the enemy had crept in. The true character of the ANC says no to corruption, in whatever form. Comrades, the decision of the 2012 Mangaung Conference was that we've come to a point now where we need to radically transform our socio-economic conditions. Now, from time to time, perhaps for populist reasons, only one part of the phrase is picked up: radical economic transformation. It is radical socio-economic transformation. Because you cannot deal with the economy alone without dealing with the people. One of the essential elements in the Constitution says that the people themselves will empower themselves to get themselves out of their own poverty. Let's empower our people.
Yes.
Let's concentrate on our people. Let's bring them back our hands. And then we will be able to make sure that all else comes after. It is our historic role, comrades. Not a single veteran should die hungry or angry. Not a single veteran should die without a house. Nobody who has served us like Ahmed Kathrada should die angry with us. Let's go out there and fill our people with hope for a better life. Let's go out there and fill our people with the dreams that we fed them. Because OR Tambo struggled to bring us home, suffered a stroke, and was not able to see the plan through to the end. He left it to us. It is our duty to carry on from where he left off and make sure that that responsibility is carried on. It is incumbent on us and we must do it. Just before I came here, comrades, my office received an announcement from this area, and the announcement indicated that this meeting that was put here today had been put together purporting to be one for Cyril Ramaphosa, because the announcement said, because he is better than I am. What I want to say to you, comrades, whatever you choose. Do not pull down the other one. It is very uncharacteristic of the ministry. Whoever pulls the other one down, indicate what your preference is and move on without detracting from the campaign of those people who support somebody.
Yes, Colonel!
Because at the bottom of this, what has brought us here today, what has given us the strength that we have, is the unity that we forged when the ANC was put together. It is an abiding principle of Tambo's that our strength is in our unity. The motto was adopted by the ANC because only together can we continue to govern. I ask you now, in the name of OR, who led us for 30 years in the wilderness, let's find each other. We will differ, but we belong to one family. ANC Tambo. ANC. Finally, the ANC will live. Finally, the ANC will always lead. And you will be united behind the banner of the ANC. As I close, comments, I want to thank you most profusely for inviting me here. I want to say to you, every time I have been asked to come and speak to the ANC, I have found it an extremely enriching experience. One, because I'm able to interact with our people. I'm able to share my knowledge with our people. But importantly for me, it renews my own belief in the ANC. The ANC is truly great. Long live the ANC! Long live!
My blessing,
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 Honourables, thank you very much.
Thank you.